Greetings, wonderful audience. Amarjeet here from Amar PTE classes. In this video, I'm going to discuss PTE different sections. As we all know, PTE different sections are speaking, reading, writing, and listening. Means sections are same to the IELTS, but in PTE, modules of the sections are different. As we all know, some sections of the PTE contributing to the another sections as well. Like speaking is contributing to the reading and the listening. But like reading, listening and writing is not contributing in the speaking section. So if you want to prepare for PTE and if you are preparing for PTE and you have the some desired score, because some students want to achieve 60 and some students have the desired score of 70 plus, or you can say 80, and some students have only 50 plus. So according to the modules, you have to prepare yourself, because all modules are not important. It depends on your scores. It means you want to which type of score. Means you want 60, you want 50, or you want 70 plus or 80. So in this video, I will share some important information about the different modules of PTE. So let's start with the speaking section. As we all know, in speaking section there are 5 modules. First is the read aloud, second is the repeat sentence, third one is the describe image, and fourth one is the retell lecture, and last one is the answer short question. So is read aloud is the first task of the speaking section, but if you are appearing in the mock test of AP Uni and if you are appearing for real PTE test, then first section of speaking is the self introduction. So you can introduce yourself if you want to introduce yourself, but if you are not preparing for your introduction, then you can skip that question as well. So first important task is read aloud. Read aloud is the most important task of the speaking section, because it is contributing 22 points in the speaking section. So these 22 points are further divided into content, then pronunciation, then fluency. So some students get confused, means content is important, ma'am, or we can skip the content. So if your English is good and you can speak every word clearly and fluently, then there is no need to skip the content. But if you are stuck between some words, means if you are facing difficulty to pronounce some words, then in that case you can skip the content, because only content part is contributing in the reading section, because read aloud is the task which is contributing in speaking as well as in the reading. So you have to try your 100%, because this is the easiest task, but sometime we get low score in read aloud. You can check your skill profile if you are appearing second time and third time. If you are getting low score in your extended speaking, it means you are facing difficulty in the read aloud. So read aloud is the most important task. If you want 50, 60, 70, 80, then this is the task. You have to improve your task. A paragraph will show on your screen and you have to read that paragraph in your natural tone. Always remember, speak in your natural tone. Don't try to copy the accent, and always speak at the moderate pace. Keep these things in mind when you are preparing for the read aloud. Now next is the repeat sentence. Repeat sentence is contributing 32 points in speaking. This is the only marking criteria of the speaking. Remember this thing. So repeat sentence is contributing 32 points, and for one repeat sentence you will get 3 points for content, 5 points for fluency, and 5 points for the pronunciation. So if you want to 60 and 70, your desired score is 50, 60 and 70, then try to repeat at least 50 and 60% of the content. Content is not important in repeat sentence. Remember this thing. Don't try to repeat the 100% content, because when you try to repeat the 100% content, then you can lose your marks in pronunciation and fluency, because sometime we get stuck between the sentence, because we start sentence with good fluency, but in the end our fluency is loose. So remember this thing in case of repeat sentence. Third one is the describe image. Describe image is the most important task, and this is the task which is contributing only in the speaking section. So it is contributing 22 points in the speaking. 22 points in the speaking means again these 22 points will again divided into further, like 5 in the content, 5 in the fluency, 5 in the pronunciation. So in this task means in the describe image, content is not important. If you are getting 15 to 20 keywords on the screen in one image, then at least try to repeat 6 to 7 keywords. Means only 6 to 7 keywords are sufficient in case of describe image. You will get 90 out of 90 in the describe image in content. But always repeat, always speak with good fluency and again with pronunciation. If you are facing difficulty to pronounce some words in case of describe image, like in case of a map, sometimes some students get stuck between some country's name. So if you are facing difficulty for some particular words, then skip that words. You can skip that words in describe image. But this task is important, most important, because you will get 3 to 4 questions in the final exam and you will get only 25 seconds to prepare this task. You can use template in this task. Means use template wisely. Don't use the template like you are repeating one line again and again. From this image I can see, from this image I can see, from this image. No, these type of strategies are not working in 2024. So use the template in which lines are different, in which lines are further connected, like firstly, secondly, in addition, furthermore, moreover. So use these type of templates. Focus on your template and focus on your pronunciation and focus on your fluency in describe image. Next is the retail lecture. Retail lecture is important if you want to get 90, 80 and 70, but if you want to achieve 60, then again it is important task. But in this task you can lose 2 to 3 points, then it's okay, because in retail lecture it is contributing only 12 points in the speaking section, but it is important. It is important, and you try, always try to note down the phrases, because in 2023 we are going through the keywords, because in 2023 keywords was working, but in 2024 keywords are not working. Try to pick up the phrases. Sometimes students get confused, ma'am, what is the phrase and what is the keyword? Keywords means you can pick one word, like retail, then again you pick lecture, then again you pick point. But in case of phrases, you have to pick the same line. You have to pick 4 or 5 words in a sequence, because computer ko bhi samajh aana chahiye ki what you are speaking. So in retail lecture, focus on your pronunciation, focus on your fluency, and also you can use the template in the retail lecture. So use template wisely and take a pause when one line is completed and focus on this task as well. Last task is the answer short question. Not important, don't try to practice it, because this is the wastage of time. So if you want 90, then you can go through this task. You can practice it for 5 to 10 minutes every day. But if you want to achieve 60 and 70, then no need to prepare this task. If you are appearing in section test and mock test, only remember those type of question. Even that case, you can get good score in the speaking section. So according to speaking, read aloud, repeat and describe, retell is the most important task. And remember this thing, speaking is contributing to another sections, but another sections are not contributing to the speaking section. This is the main reason why some students got less marks in speaking. So next is the writing section. In writing section, all modules are important. Remember this thing, all modules are important. So these are the modules which are contributing in writing section. First is the write from dictation. Write from dictation is the part of the listening section, and this is the last task of the PTE and last task of the listening. But it is contributing 27 points in the writing section. Remember, 27 points. So improve your write from dictation. As we all know, this is the task similar to the repeat sentence. In repeat sentence, you have to repeat the same sentence, but in write from dictation you have to write that sentence. In write from dictation you can change the sequence of words, but in this task first try to understand the sentence, try to remember the sentence, because if your write from dictation is not good and if you in the final exam you are facing difficulty in write from dictation and you are confused, my write from dictation is good or bad, but if your write from dictation is not good, it is bad, then you can lose your overall score as well, because this is the task which can affect your overall score plus your writing score plus your listening score. So try to improve your write from dictation. Next is the reading and writing filling the blanks. So reading and writing filling the blanks, as students hear the name of reading then they get fumble. But अब हम क्या करें, हमें reading तो नहीं आती, we can't understand the context. Try to understand the context, this is the only solution, because if you are trying to remember, if you are trying to memorize the things, you are trying to memorize the answer, then in final exam you can get blank. So in reading and writing filling the blanks, contributing 22 points in the writing, but if you want to 60, then according to me 15 points are enough. If your read aloud is good, then you can say ki if your 15 blanks are correct, then you can get good score in reading as well as in the writing. So reading and writing, for reading and writing filling the blanks as such there is no tricks, because this is the basic knowledge of grammar is very important for reading and writing, and understanding of context is very important. But if your target score is 80 or 70 plus, then you have to focus on reading and writing filling the blanks as well, because this is the crucial task. So focus on this task. Next is the write an essay. Write an essay is the easiest task and you can follow the template in write an essay, and it is contributing 12 points in writing section only. So you can use template. Templates are working in 2024 also, but use the template wisely. Content is equally important in template. If your template is of 200 words or 190 words, then it's not enough. You can lose the point of content. So include the content, include the lines of the content, also you can include the phrases, and also you can pick up the keywords from the content. So write an essay is contributing only in the writing section. Next is the summarize spoken text. Yes, summarize spoken text is also sometime crucial, because in 2023 keywords were working, you can use the keywords and you can put that keywords in the template. But in 2024 keywords are not working. You have to pick up the phrases. Only phrases are working in 2024. So remember this thing. Summarize spoken text contributing 12 points in the writing. So some time kya hota hai ki if you are not able to hear the audio and if you are not able to pick up the correct phrases from the audio, then you can lose your points in the writing section. Because if you are writing the keywords like is, am, are, this, those, that, were, these are not the keywords, these are not the phrases. Try to pick up the lines that are relevant to the content, that are relevant to the audio. So choose that type of phrases. Only in that case you can achieve good marks. And also try to keep within the word limits, like 50 to 70 words. If you are writing 49 words or you are writing 70 words, then your question will not further will be checked, because you will get 0 points in the form and you will also get 0 points for that particular question. Next is the summarize written text. Summarize written text is the first module of the writing, but it is contributing 10 points and according to me this is free of cost. Means you have to do nothing. you have to just pick up the lines and put the connectors. So you can pick first line as it is, then use the connector butt, then you can use the second line, then use the connector hence, then pick up the third line from the given summary. But again, take care of the word limit, 50 to 70 words, and time limit is 10 minutes. This is the easiest task of the PTE according to me. Next is the listening, filling the blanks. Yes, listening, filling the blanks are important, but if your desired score is only 60 and 50 plus, then you can skip 2 to 3 points. But you have to focus on these points. If your reading and writing, filling the blanks is not good, then you have to focus on listening, filling the blanks. If your desired score is 60 and 50 plus, but if your desired score is 70 plus or 90, then you have to focus on all these points. Write from dictation, reading and writing, filling the blanks, write an essay, summarize spoken text, summarize written text, and listening, filling the blanks. But if you are stuck in between 50 to 70 points of PTE, then you can manage between in these two. Means if you are weak in reading and writing, filling the blanks, then improve your listening, filling the blanks. And if your listening is weak, then try to improve your reading and writing, filling the blanks. So this is all about writing section. Next is the reading section. So in reading section contributes 45 points to the reading, and other sections also contribute 45 points to the reading. So if your desired score is 60 and 50, then you can easily get 50-60 points in the reading section. But if your desired score is more than 70, then you have to focus on the all modules of the reading section. So let's start with the reading section. First is the read aloud. As I already discussed, 22 points. Read aloud is contributing 22 points in the speaking, same 22 points in the reading section as well. Content of the read aloud is contributing in the speaking section, reading section. So if you are missing the content, your points of reading will be also missed. So focus on your content, because sometime when we are reading the paragraph, then we can mispronounce is, am, are, of, the, it, then you can lose your points of reading. Remember this thing. If you are preparing from scratch, if you are new in PTE, then focus on content as well. Next is reading and writing, filling the blanks. You can use the basic knowledge of grammar, and you can also use different type of collocations, but understanding of the context is most important in reading and writing, filling the blanks. And again, it is contributing 22 points in the reading. So if your desired score is 50 or 60, then try to at least 15 points. Try to at least for 15 points in reading and writing, filling the blanks. Means if in one paragraph there are 5 blanks, so at least 3 blanks will be correct. Focus on your desired score. Next is the reading, filling the blanks. Reading, filling the blanks is easy as compared to reading and writing, filling the blanks, because here we have so many options. But in reading, filling the blanks, if there are 4 blanks, then you will get 8 options, and you have to choose from that options. So reading, filling the blanks is contributing 15 points to the reading section, and this is the task of the reading section, and this is only contributing in the reading section. So reading, filling the blanks is not contributing to the other sections. Remember this thing. But this is the important task, and if your desired score is 50, 60 and 70 plus, but you have to focus on both type of blanks, reading and writing and reading, filling the blanks. Next is the summarize written text, easiest task of PTE. As I already discussed, you can use the connectors. You can choose the first line as it is, then put a semicolon, then use the connector but, then put comma, give a space, choose the second line, then again put semicolon, choose the connector hence and comma, then give a space. So if try to write within the form, means try to write within 50 to 70 words. If you are writing 49 words or you are writing 70 words, then you lose your point of form. So automatically you will get 0 point for that particular question, and you will get one question in the final exam. So This is the summarized written text. Next is the highlight incorrect words. So this is the part of the listening section. So highlight incorrect word is the easiest task, but this task has a negative marking. Means if there are 5 words in one paragraph and you are marking 6 words, and then you will get only 4 points. Means this task has a negative marking. So if you are not sure about one particular word, then skip that word. So it's better to get 4 points instead of the 5 points in highlight incorrect words. So do this task very carefully, improve your listening skill and focus on the screen as well as keep your focus on the audio. Because if you are skipping some words, then you can lose points in listening as well as in the reading section. Next is the reorder paragraph. If your desired score is 50 and 60, then you can skip this particular module. Means reorder paragraph is not important. If your desired score is 60, then you have no need to waste your time on this task. But if you are planning for 70 and 80, then you have to do this task. You can follow some rules, you can follow tips and tricks for this task, but some of the tricks and some of the tips will not work in reorder paragraph. So you have to make the pairs. In reorder paragraph, understanding of context, again it is important, because reading is based on the understanding. You can follow some rules of grammar, but understanding is very important in case of reading section. So these are the tasks of the reading section which are most important if you are planning for 50, 60 and 70 plus. So this is the task from reading section. MCQ multiple answers contributing 3 points in the reading section, but in MCQ multiple answers you will get 2 questions in the final exam, 1 to 2 questions. It depend on the number of questions, but again this MCQ multiple answer has the negative marking. So in which option you are sure, then choose only that option. Next is the MCQ single answer contributing 1 point to the reading section. If you are sure, then you can choose the answer, but you can skip this task. It is not important. This is the least important task. Next is the highlight correct summary. This task is from the listening section, contributing 2 points in reading. If you are able to choose the correct option, then you can go for it, but no need to prepare for this task. Don't waste your time on this task. Only prepare for these tasks for the reading section if you want to improve your reading. Remember, read aloud, then summarize written text, highlight incorrect word. These 3 tasks will contribute 45 points to the reading. And reading and writing, reading filling the blanks, reorder paragraph, then MCQ single, MCQ multiple will also contribute 45 points. So divide your points. If you are getting good score, if you are getting good score during the mock test in read aloud, highlight incorrect words, summarize written text, then you can easily get good in reading section. Because if you are getting 40 out of 45 from other section, then you can achieve 30 from reading also. So it's good if you are achieving that score. Then focus on your reading skill. Last is the listening section. First task of the listening section, according to listening point of view, repeat sentence. As I already told you, repeat sentence, content of the repeat sentence is contributing in the listening section. And content of the repeat sentence will contribute 20 points to the listening. So if you are repeating 50% content, then it's good for speaking. But if you are speaking 60 and 70%, then this is also good for listening. So you can also improve your listening from these tasks, but if you can speak sentence with good content, then it's good. But if you can't speak the sentence with good content, then it is good for if you are repeating 50% content. So try to repeat the 50% content, but remember this point also. If you are skipping the content, then you can lose point in listening. So if you want to achieve 80 and 70 plus, then focus on the content of the repeat sentence. But if your desired score is only 60, then it's not matter. means you can focus on pronunciation and fluency. It's upon you. 50% content is enough. But sometime we hear the video, we see the videos on the YouTube, means you can repeat anything. You can repeat extra line, you can add extra line. No, you will not get any point for pronunciation and fluency. You will get point for pronunciation and fluency if you are repeating the same line. Remember this point in the repeat sentence. Next is the write from dictation. Write from dictation will contribute 20 points in the listening. So try to write the line and try to listen the line as well. Try to understand the line. Write from dictation will contribute 20 points in the listening. Next is the summarize spoken text. Summarize spoken text will contribute 13 points in the listening section. You will hear an audio and you have to write that audio. You can follow the template in this task and you can pick up the phrases, as I already told you. Next is the retail lecture. Content of the retail lecture will contribute listening. So if you are picking 5 phrases or you are picking 6 phrases, then it's enough. You will get 90 out of 90 in the content. You can follow the template, but try to pick up the phrases so that computer can understand what you are speaking. Next is the highlight incorrect words. Highlight incorrect words will contribute 8 points to the listening and 9 points to the reading. Improve your listening to get good score in highlight incorrect words, because I think this is the easiest task. You have just hear an audio and you have to match the words with the audio and you have to highlight only that words. So improve your listening skills if you want to improve your highlight incorrect words, because some students face difficulty in this task also. I go through many students. Next is the listening, filling the blanks, important task of the listening section. It is contributing 7 points to the listening and 7 points to the writing as well. So focus on this task, improve your writing, improve your spellings and improve your basic knowledge of grammar, because sometime we get a paragraph that is based on the grammar. So use your grammar as well, but improve your listening as well and focus on your spellings part for write from dictation and for listening, filling the blanks as well, and for summarize spoken text. Next is the answer short question. Answer short question will contribute 6 points to the listening, but you can skip this task. Next is the select missing word, only 1 point in the listening. MCQ multiple answers, 3 points to the listening. MCQ single answer, 1 point to the listening. And highlight correct summary, 1 point to the listening section. So if you are planning for 50 to 60, then this is enough for listening, filling the blanks. Means these are the tasks if you are preparing for 50 and 60. But if you want to achieve 90, then you can also prepare these tasks. But according to me, there is no need to waste your time on these tasks, because this is the task if you are preparing for mock test, sections text, then during that test you can prepare these tasks. So this is from my side. If you have any queries, if you have any questions and you want any kind of help, then you can write in the comment box. You can also mail me at amarpteclasses@gmail.com, and my contact number is given in the description. If you want to take online and offline classes, then you can contact me. And don't forget to share these videos with your friends and subscribe to my channel as well. Thank you so much for watching this video.